Myself, Ms. Rachna Jain, Associate Professor, Department of English, Government PG College, Rajgarh, Alwar. Today in this video lecture, I am going to give you the detailed summary of the short story, The Open Window, which is in the syllabus of BA Part 1st, English Literature, Paper 2nd. This is my second video lecture on this topic. The Open Window is an interesting story. Frampton Nuttall is the main character of the story. He reached out to the countryside to get cured of his disease. The story opened in a house where a girl was attending to her guest in the absence of her aunt. She was a girl of 15 years named Veera. Mr. Nuttall was apprehensive if he could find a cure for his nerve disease. He thought of his sister who advised and sent him to the countryside with a letter of introduction. She was skeptical of his improvement in health unless he visits a quiet and peaceful place. After a few minutes of silence, the girl Veera inquired if he knew anyone in the surrounding. He gently answered that he was new to the place and it was his sister who stayed there about 4 years ago. He also spoke in a regretful tone about the reference letter. The girl tried to confirm if he really didn't know the people around. Frampton pondered about the state of Mrs. Sappleton while looking around in the room. The girl started concocting a story about Mrs. Sappleton that her husband and two brothers with a spaniel went for hunting. They did not return. Their bodies were not found. That is why she kept the French window open. She often told her that her husband would enter with a waterproof coat over his arm and Ronnie, her youngest brother, would sing, "Bertie, who do you bound?" to tease her. She further added that even she started believing, then entered Mrs. Sappleton asking for forgiveness of delay. She was certain that Veera must have entertained him with her craft of telling stories. She informed him about her family members who went out for shooting for snipe in the marshes. She was worried about her carpet as they would spoil that with muddy shoes. She kept on saying about the scarcity of birds and prospects for duck in the winter. Frampton was on his nerves when he related the two stories of the ladies of the house. Frampton called it an unfortunate coincidence that he visited on the anniversary of such a tragic ailments. He told her that the doctors advised him to take complete rest and to avoid anything in the nature of violent physical exercise. Mrs. Sappleton's eyes were anxiously waiting for her husband and then came shine in her eyes when she saw them approaching. Through the most horrified, Frampton looked at Veera and stared at the window. Three figures entered, walking across the lawn towards the window carrying their arms. Then her brother teased her again by saying, "Bertie, why do you bound?" Terrified with unnamed fear, Frampton picked up his things and went away almost, colliding with a cyclist. Mrs. Sappleton told her husband about Mr. Nuttall, about who asked at sudden withdrawal. Mrs. Sappleton was also taken aback at such a gesture. Veera explained that once he had experienced a horror of dogs. He was once hunted into a cemetery and had to spend a night there. The story ended at the brevity and storytelling quality of the girl. Though it is a remarkably short piece of fiction, The Open Window explores a number of important themes. Mr. Nuttall comes to the country in an attempt to cure his nervous condition. He pays a visit to the home of Mrs. Sappleton in order to introduce himself, and before he gets to meet the matron of the house, he is intercepted by her niece, who regales him with an artful piece of fiction that in the end only makes his nervous condition worse. So first theme is appearance and reality. It is no surprise that Mrs. Sappleton's niece tells a story that is easy to believe. She begins with an object in plain view, an open window, and proceeds from there. The window is obviously open, but for the reasons for its being open, the reader is completely at the mercy of Mrs. Sappleton's niece Vera, at least while she tells her story. The open window becomes a symbol within this story, within a story, and its appearance becomes its reality. When Mr. Nuttall and the reader are presented with a contrary reality at the end of the story, the result is a tension between appearance and reality that needs to be resolved. Which is real? Can they both be real? Second point is deception. Were it not for deception, this story could not happen. The action and irony of the story revolve around the apparent deception that Mrs. Sappleton's niece practices. It remains to be seen, however, whether this deception is a harmless prank or the result of a sinister disposition. If the niece's deception is cruel, then the reader must question the motives behind the deception practiced by all the tellers of the stories, including Saki himself. Third theme is sanity or insanity. The open window shows just now how fine the line can be between sanity and insanity. Mr. Nettles, susceptible to the deceit, is no different from that of the reader of the story. Yet Mr. Nuttall is insane and the reader presumably is not. In order to maintain this distinction, Saki forces his reader to consider the nature of insanity and its causes. Thus the writer H.H. Munro set the story in a rural area. The story revolves around an open window. Although it is an object, the girl weaved a narrative around it. She concocted a story that scared away the guest. She again made up a story and gave the scene a new twist. The swiftness and brevity in her creating a narrative were extraordinary. That's all for the day. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.